Okay, so here is the first page of Appendix C, and I have the page anchored down outside on the tripod, so you cannot see the bottom of it, but you can see the top of it. And we have our appendix of knot shapes, it seems. There's our trefoil at the top. And then 4 sub 1, and then it goes down to 5 sub 1, etc. There's the open bracket and some integer addition and subtraction, and I've been doodling around, and I think I may have figured out what that is, maybe not. This appears to be backwards, which is a problem, but I can see it from the camera, so that's nice. So, I'm going to start making these with this little piece of rope, and I made some markings on it down the center line, so we can see if it starts with the center line up and then ends with it turned maybe around. And maybe that has to do with that 1 minus 1 is. So I'm just going to make this shape. We're going to, let's just start it at the top. We'll start it at the top with the black core facing up, so it goes down and around and then back under. And then it connects. How nice. Okay, so it appears that the line is entirely facing up. However, while I was making that, it did seem to need to turn over, but then it turned back over. Imagine that. And so let's see if we can figure out where the first place that it turns up to. Well, okay. So where did, okay, started this, pretending it was the top, and then this comes down, and to make this turn back under, it kinda turns, like it doesn't have to, but it does have to go back before it comes back forward and turns under. I feel like it's a lot easier to do that if you flip it entirely over, and it kind of makes a 90 degree turn, but it doesn't, well, you know, it kind of does have to, because it does have to change directions that way. Well, hold on, if we were to connect this back over here, it would still be pointing this, so it seems like when we connect it back, it goes to the minus one. I don't know. I mean, does it really need to flip over to do that? I mean, it seems like, because the bicolor, the book said something about the bicolor, and this is very stiff, so it doesn't like to be twisted, and as it twists, it kind of like... Hey. Kind of pops the threads up, or pops the weave up, so it kind of really likes to stay in the same place. So let's move on. We're going to do 4 sub 1, aka 3 minus 1. So does that mean 2? Oh, and then on the this one, it has the top number is 3, and then on this one, it's 2, 2, or 22. I'm not sure if that's, like, a set of integers, or a one integer, or a set of single digits. So, let's see if we can find out. So this one, I'll start with the core facing up. It crosses over itself, which is fine, but to go back under, it has to go down and around. So it seems like we can do that. And then one of these needs to go through the hole at the top, and we can just make that this one, but this has to like go like back and like around. To connect. Well, it seems like if I do that, when it gets back, it has rotated, I would say clockwise, 90 degrees, but that also might not be right, because, well, oh, I should probably have pulled that and see what happens. So we have one crossing, two crossing, and then this comes over, and there's a third crossing, and then the fourth crossing over here, which makes this. Oh, I did that again, and it seemed to have rotated twice again, because it has to come up and back, and then down and back, or and down, huh? And then, well, okay, anyways, we can pull on that, and we have the nice figure 8, which is 3 minus 1, and we can put this face up, and they both end up face up, so that doesn't seem to go with what I was hypothesizing, so there's that. Okay, let's do the next one. This one is 5 sub 1, 1 minus 1 plus 1. Great. So I'm going to start in what is my top right corner. Or the rightmost, verticalmost side. So that comes, and when it gets here, it goes behind, and then it comes back over, and then it goes under, and it comes back over, and it goes under, and then we get back to here. And just doing that quickly, it does appear to have rotated 90 degrees. Oh, and this other, it also says 5, it's right in the crease there, so I didn't, oh, okay, that just like totally turned as I pulled on it, so whatever that means. And if this side is face up, then this side is face down. So the bike collar fully flips 180 degrees at some point in there. So that's 1 minus 1 plus 1. And there are 5 thingies. I wonder if that's like how many times through the cycle it will take to put it back into its original orientation, maybe? Okay, but this is a handy little thing. Seems like you could put a knot, make a little handhold thinger. I'll bet you could put something through there too and latch that on there, and then it would not go anywhere. And that's just the 5-sub-1. Okay, so I'm gonna do the 5-sub-2 as the last one right now. This one's a little more squiggly. It's the first one with the sub-2. The other ones just had the sub-1. And I'm guessing, and then it's a 3-2, and it has 32, or 3 and 2-somethings. Great. So, I'm going to start this one with a loop, like the bottom, that one, no, that one, the center of the page one. I'm going to start there and just work my fingers down to here, and wait, no, that's that one. I'll work, go over that one and work them back to here. Yes. Very good. Or, no. Okay. I will start here and then work. I will break here and then pull that and start with a loop here. Okay, very good. So that goes there. This one comes back and over, which means that this one goes under, over, under. So we have this shape. I am apparently getting a little bit better at this, and these connect here, and it appears to have lined up, but that doesn't really matter because it's gonna go where it goes. Okay, so that made this. Seems like it could be handy, like, makes, you could put a carabiner on there and then put weight on it. Seems like that would hold very well. I noticed that's a feature of a lot of the, like, the next 4. It seems like you can do that at some place on, so maybe one is better than the other or something. Now, so if this side is up, which was the, what is the starting side? Well, anyways, if this side is up, then that side is down. Very good. So that's 3-2, and that's 5-2, so this crosses over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. I'm not quite sure in what specific dimension this is different, but I'm starting to figure it out, maybe. This one seems like it's more related to the trefoil, but with an extra loop. Yeah, so this is actually just kind of like a loop. It's like it twists up and then it goes through the hole. So it's almost kind of like because it's coiled up so that the bicolor goes through the tubular neighborhood with an even peel. And so to get it to do that, you have to move it in three dimensions, apparently. Oh god, can I undo that? Oh dear, I think I just undid it to where. No, well, so, okay, it had a twist in it. And then it came around and then. Wait, I think I just made a figure eight. No, I just. Okay, whatever. Anyways, it's something pretty close to that. We'll work more on that next time.